It's easy to be strong and look strong, but it's really... It's really hard. Then you just can't hold on to it anymore. This is the first time I've broken down. Sorry. The hardest part is just seeing people feel like there's no hope. But there's lots of hope. You just have to be faithful. Our marriage was destroyed. And it didn't feel like we could ever be able to rebuild. We repaired it. And I'm hoping that the people here will feel the same when they rebuild.
How did you guys meet?
That's a funny story.
I met a friend. He and his wife introduced us together as a blind date.
Yeah.
And we just seemed to hit it off really well. I said, this is a lady I want to spend the rest of my life with. So I asked her to marry me that night.
The night that we met.
The very night we met.
I said yes. It's kind of crazy thinking about it. We both have PTSD. We were going through a really tough time, and it was hard for us to kind of communicate. A friend of ours told us about Samaritan's Purse, and they were taking wounded warriors up to Alaska. And so they brought us back together, and they showed us how to become a couple instead of just two people in the same home.
Everything that the chaplains taught us in Alaska was all biblically based, and we know where to find the answers now, and it makes a world of difference.
Both got baptized, and then we rededicated our marriage back in Alaska in 2016. The problems that we had, they all went away. Not saying that we don't have rough times, but if we hadn't gone to Alaska, we probably wouldn't be together.
With what Operation Heal Our Patriots has done for us, we wanted to give back, and that's why we're here.
People were there to help us when we were hurting. We want to turn around and do the same for them. When you talk to them on the phone and you're telling them what you're going to try to do, and you just tell them that you love them. I was talking to one lady, and she was very devastated, and I said, you know, if I could be there to just give you a big old hug, I said I would.
I'm not a lumberjack. I'm not a plumber, I'm not an electrician, I'm not a carpenter. I'm just a set of hands that's here to help. The ability to help other people, it also helps us because we realize that with God's help, nothing's impossible. No matter what you go through, there's hope, there's light. The battle's already been won. Jesus Christ was raised from the dead, and he's coming back again. And despite the devastation, God still won. As long as we keep him at the forefront, we're gonna make it.